Let's dig in deep today. The first thing I want to cover is the Fed's open secret. We are going to continue off with what we talked about in yesterday's video. The second thing I want to look at is the economic headwinds. I'm going to be showing you what's happening with the prices rising, the shortages, and so many other factors. And the third thing I want to look at is debt. And we are talking about this on all levels, including the potential debt ceiling disaster that happens about every 6 months or so. That and more. Let's go. Continuing on with what we had yesterday, I am showing you this article here. Fed official who warned on real estate traded REITs actively. Isn't that funny? Look at this. Financial disclosures show Boston's Rosengren held 4 REITs. And we're not talking about small figures either, but the point is simply to highlight what is happening. The Federal Reserve is actively buying the mortgage-backed securities with what they used to call toxic debt. Okay, now they're simply buying it all up. That's supporting the real estate market. And then you've got guys like this that are swooping in and taking advantage. One of the Federal Reserve's largest internal critics of the risks in the US real estate was an active investor in the sector last year. Rosengren listed stakes in 4 separate real estate investment trusts and disclosed multiple purchases and sales in those and other securities. But of course, don't worry, it's all legit, it's all good, as it might be. According to the rules, he's not doing anything wrong. That's not the point. The point is what they are trying to do actively. Are they supporting themselves, or are they supporting the economy as they tell us? All right, they're just showing you right here how they've, you know, all the things that they've done. Rosengren's 2020 disclosure shows that he bought and sold shares of, they mention the particular companies here. The Fed is buying $40 billion of this every single month, mortgage-backed securities. And I believe personally that this is something that we should be keeping an eye on. All right. All transactions were reviewed by the general counsel. They were all in compliance and so on. Look, this is what we need to understand. This is the mortgage-backed securities. This is what they've been doing month after month after month. The general trend here since 2020 has been a massive acceleration, the likes of which we have never seen before. They have $2.4 trillion worth of this stuff. And they're not going to, when they taper, they're not going to pull back on the amount of treasuries. We're not going to see the mortgage-backed securities decline. No. It's the rate at which it's rising. So you're going to see this kind of taper off a little bit, and it starts to slow down, but it still will be increasing. Remember that. It's just the rate at which they are buying. Imagine this, the Federal Reserve printing money out of thin air. They go into this market and they buy it all up. And then you have people on the inside, and we're talking about insiders within the Fed at the highest levels, and they are going in and just saying, all right, if they're going to buy the mortgage-backed securities, I'm going to buy this. And then you got Kaplan saying, hey, if they're buying Apple, if they are bailing that company out, why not just buy some Apple shares as a guarantee? And that's what's happening here. But nobody wants to talk about it because that's negative. And I understand the way this thing works. The shadow banning is real. Anyway, Eventbrite sheds most of its San Francisco office space a year after mass layoffs. This is a trend that will continue. You will see commercial real estate continue to be a very, very bad space. However, this could change. I want to tell you that this could change. I've talked about the potential before. This could be converted into real estate for people to live in. There's no doubt about that, as well as the potential to actually be growing food indoors. There are many other applications. Possibly. However, this remains to be seen. At this time right now, it's not looking good because so many businesses are simply either already getting rid of their buildings or they're waiting for their leases to end, whatever makes sense for them. Look, another tech company is shedding a large chunk of its San Francisco offices. Eventbrite is moving out of its main headquarters a year after it laid off 45% of the staff. They get into the details, but I just wanted to simply highlight the fact that this is not the first business to do this. There are many of them. And then we look at this. Amazon, one of those companies that's been buying up lots of real estate for obvious reasons. Well, as they say in this article out of the AP, there will be something missing at two Whole Foods stores opening next year. The rows of cashiers. They are going to the cashierless type stores as they have in their smaller operations. Now they want to expand this to the Whole Foods. When they had done, the whole acquisition of Whole Foods initially, this was kind of understood that they were going in this direction. And now apparently this will be the case next year. That connects in with this. 2.2 million more job openings than unemployed workers. So for these businesses, remember, whatever you think about the issue, that I cover the economics. I am only covering the economic aspects. When you're looking at these corporations, what do you think they care about? They care about the corporate profits. They care about the shareholders, the stakeholders, and so on. This just shows you that when there is a crisis, a jobs crisis that they are dealing with, what do you think they're going to do? They're going to figure out a way to eliminate all those jobs. Hey, we're having trouble getting cashiers. All right, we'll go to the self-checkout. All right, we want to reduce the amount of employees that we have. We don't want to have that individual there, one individual per four or six self-checkouts. How do we get rid of that? Let's just get rid of the checkout entirely. Then we don't need those employees anymore. That's what's being implemented today. You see at all of the, one note I wanted to make was the fact that I think it's McDonald's or one of the big companies there was actually testing an artificial intelligence for the drive-through system. Then you got Flippy the robot that's doing all the hamburgers and the French fries. They're doing this on all levels. That might not be desirable positions, maybe not, but it still pays some money. Okay, so this is what's happening. If there is a potential to eliminate the job, they're doing it, just like they're doing in the financial industry with the robo-advisor. So don't think it's not coming for the higher paid wages and salaries, okay? This article here is simply talking about the companies, Sherwin-Williams as one, being a paint company, saying, look, we can't do this right now. And actually their stock went down simply because they said the raw materials are so expensive. They're in shortage. We can't deal with it. We're having a lot of problems. They do get into, what the actual CEO had said and so on. But I just wanted to highlight the fact that companies all along, top to bottom, A to Z, they are all feeling the pressure right now for different reasons. And then that connects in with what we're seeing in the Fed's beige book. The Fed's beige book is essentially just getting from all of the different Fed locations. It's just they bring all the data together in this one report. Overall economic activity, and essentially saying you've got problems, but there is a deceleration. There's a deceleration in economic activity, largely attributable to the pullback in dining out, travel, and tourism, saying people are concerned and so on. All I'm showing you here from multiple different levels, I've shown you what's happening at the restaurants. I've shown you what's happening in travel. I've shown you all these different things in chart form previously, last week I think it was, that things are starting to taper off and starting to decline somewhat. Whether that's going to collapse, of course, we don't know that. But all I'm showing you here is that the data is adding up. And that initial boost, which is from the stimulus, nothing else, it's from the stimulus, is wearing off. And that, of course, spells disaster unless they can get another round going. The economy is entering a new phase, a new era, and this is all weakness, more weakness, and more weakness. But on the other hand, you have stocks ignoring what's happening in the economy, and they're simply relying on the devaluation of the currency. Regardless of all of that, people must be prepared and must have their stuff all in order right now. Don't wait for things to get worse. Debt is going to skyrocket and shortages are getting much worse today. All right, way too much to cover, but I need to touch on a lot of these points here. We're going to move through really quickly. Stay with me. 85% of the U.S. high yield market currently yields below U.S. CPI. So imagine that. The high yield is actually negative. That's insane to think about. This is just showing you the market cap to GDP ratio, the Buffett indicator, at a level we have never seen before, much, much further than we were back in the year 2000. For my friends in Europe, check this out. European energy crunch, day ahead, UK electricity prices climb to a record high. All right, again, wind is generating very, very little. Gas is super pricey, and there you go. Okay, so we are seeing the expensive, basically everything is so expensive today. Whatever the reason is, to me, that doesn't matter so much. I just want to know how it's affecting you. That's what I try to put together. That's what I'm trying to show you here. And then you have Janet Yellen. Oh my goodness. The US is on track to default on national debt in October. Yes, 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 Janet Yellen, we've heard it all before. They make it seem as if there is a debt ceiling. Look, this is a quote. Waiting until the last minute to suspend or increase the debt limit can cause serious harm to business and consumer confidence, raise short-term borrowing costs for taxpayers, and negatively impact the credit rating of the United States. And simply saying, we fully expect Congress to act promptly to suspend the debt limit and protect the full faith and credit of the U.S. And they're going to make that happen. Right, right, right. Probably just a copy and paste from what was said from Munchkin before her and all the rest before that. It's a joke because we know that the debt ceiling is simply fictional. They will just spend any amount of money. It's not real. Now look at this. We're talking about negative rates in this Wall Street Journal article. I found it to be interesting. They're also talking about the central bank digital currencies, which is something that has been in news more, but also something that I've been covering more often and something I've been thinking about, how they can implement it very easily. On the left-hand side, you're seeing a chart, negative times. Policy guidelines such as the Taylor rule imply rates should turn negative in serious crises. Yes, yes, yes. That's what they're saying. Who knows? Who really knows? But this is the point I wanted to touch on. Deeply negative rates won't come straight away. Initially, central bank digital currencies will almost certainly be designed to behave as much like ordinary banknotes as possible to make their adoption easy and minimize disruption, while the use of physical cash will be allowed to wither away. How's that sound? How does that sound? Hey? But I think there's a little bit, you know, this is convoluted a little bit because the central bank digital currency is something very different than just having a cashless society. Because right now you could be using your debit card and credit card and so on. I think part of the implementation here will be stores that will say it's become too expensive for us and it's become too dangerous for us to hold cash in the store. We only accept plastic. So I think that could be the way that it becomes implemented on that level. The central bank digital currency, that's a whole different level because we're skipping the banks unless there's something else we don't know about. Central banks are making lots of efforts to make sure that the CBDC isn't seen as a possible monetary policy instrument. My take is that the discussion will come only later. So I don't know how they're going to implement it. I really don't. And there, you know, my thoughts here is that this is all going to be part of a new universal basic income. And that's how they get the people to accept this cashless society. You put them into a situation in which they are very weakened. And so, you know, they're going to have to accept whatever they can get. Oh, that's the way the free money is coming through. That's the way the social assistance is coming through. Okay, I'll accept it. I'm forced to. We'll see. And this right here is just talking about how they are planning, they're planning on trying to implement a system that will have all of your transactions, all of your transactions that go through directly reported to the IRS. Some might say that's good because then those people, they can't get away with it. But do you want to be scrutinized by this type of institution? I'm not sure that's exactly a beneficial thing. Okay, before I finish off, just want to show you right here, I am in the middle of writing up another one of these PDFs that is going to talk about preparedness, something that I think right now, more people should be getting into, okay? Five tips to be more self-sufficient. So stay tuned for that. I'm working on these slowly and I'm going to get them out, and every single video is going to contain some really good information, practical tips. So, you know, bear with me as I go through it. Look, if you're not an insider already, that's where I'm going to be able to give people these PDFs. So join up. I will make sure that you get access to these in the future. That is available right here at this card or at themoneygps.com. If you haven't already, you got to support this channel simply by giving a thumbs up. Remember, if you don't give a thumbs up, Janet Yellen doesn't give me the shoulder massage and back massage. So I really need those thumbs up. If we can get those thumbs up to hit, let's say 10,000 thumbs up, then I'm going to be in the good books. Okay, so definitely help me out. And if you haven't already, you wanna watch this video. It's about the Federal Reserve and what's happening with Kaplan and so many other things. Check it, and I'll see you there.